Today's video will be on my normal foundation, highlight, and contour routine. Now, I must let you guys know that I do have extremely oily skin. So today, I'll be showing you products that work on my oily skin and that actually last more than 6 hours, even if I don't blot. So without further chatter from me, because you guys know I will talk you to death, I'm going to go ahead and jump right into the video. And don't forget to subscribe below. Welcome. I'll come in the video with my eyebrows and my eyeshadow already done. First, I'll be going in and priming my face with the NYX Angel Mineral Veil primer. And then I'm going to be using a second primer. I'm going to be using the Makeup Forever Step 1 primer as well. And I'll be using that only in my T-zone. For the simple fact that I like to keep the areas that I'm extremely oily extra matte so that the makeup doesn't separate on my face. So that's what you see me doing now. Next, I'll be going in with the Maybelline Fit Me Setting Powder. And I will be setting the primer. This, once again, puts a barrier between my skin and the makeup that I'm putting on it. It also absorbs oil. So this process has really helped my makeup to be lasting, which allows it to last for more than 8 hours. Next, I'll be going in and I will be color correcting. I'll be doing the normal orange under my eyes and beautiful bronze over the remainder of my face. I'll use L.A. Girl Pro Concealer. And I've learned that using as little as possible and putting a light layer on actually helps when you have oily skin, because it doesn't bog your skin down with product and it allows it to breathe as much as it possibly can with the product. And then I take a stippling brush, just the one I got for a buck off of Wish. Actually, the whole set I think was like $1. I'm off of Wish, and I just begin to blend it in. And with using a brush, it allows me to use less product because it doesn't soak up as much product. And I just blend that out. My next step after that is I will be actually going into foundation once I blend all of this out. And I'm going to be using the Revlon Colorstay foundation. I actually use it in the color 410, and that is Cappuccino. And then I'll be using 375, and I use that in the areas under my eyes, which allows me to not actually have to highlight as much as I would if I used the darker color under my eyes. And right now I think that one is 375 and it's toffee. And then I'll go in and I'll blend the darker color first, and then I begin to use the lighter color and blend that out. And I just use a stippling brush to blend in first, because once again, it allows me to use less product. And then I go in with a Real Techniques sponge and I just blend it out. And it gives it more of an airbrushed finish when I do it that way. Also, it allows the sponge to soak up any excess makeup and gives me more of a semi-matte finish. Next, I'm going to be highlighting with the Nars Radiant and Creamy Concealer, and it is in Amande. I hope I'm saying that right. But I actually normally did not use this, but I tried it and I am in love with this stuff. Next, I use the Shape Tape. I actually bought that in the wrong color and I'm not paying attention to the box I picked up. And so what I do with that to give me a more radiant and lifted highlight, I begin to just put a little bit on my face in the areas I highlight. Next, you're going to see me contour with a creamed contour, and I will be using the Radiant and Creamy Contour Palette in medium to dark, and then I'll begin to blend that in, as well as I'm allowing the makeup, the concealer, to sit under my eye so that it would have more of a full coverage under my eye. So that's why that is actually still sitting there. But right now I'm just blending out this contour. And doing it this way actually allows all the colors to mesh together more seamlessly than one color sticking out from the other. That's why I continue to use the same side of the sponge, because I want all the makeup to mesh and my makeup to look more seamless. I'll be setting my highlighted areas with the Sacha Buttercup setting powder. I do not bake. I just put a light layer of setting powder in those areas and I sort of set it and forget it. Now there I did get a little overzealous with the setting powder, but as you can tell, I began to just blend it out a little bit and it was okay. Next, I am using the Fit Me powder. And I am actually taking that and setting the remainder of my face. Once again, I set around the areas of my mouth and my nose that I get extremely oily. Next, I take a sponge and I just press that powder into my face. This allows any excess powder or product to once again be removed from my face. Next, I'll be using the Black Radiance pressed powder in Rich Mahogany to warm up my face with a little more of a powder contour. Then I'm going to use the Fit Me blush in Berry just to put a little more color back into my cheeks. I love blush, you guys. Then I'm going to use the Maybelline highlight, and it's in the color mauve. I love this thing. I am actually hitting pan now because I love that thing so much. Next, I'm going to actually use this sort of brown matte lipstick. I actually got it from Sephora because I was looking for a really brown lipstick and I don't really remember the name of it. If I can find it, I will post it below. If I can't, I'm sorry. But I'm also adding to that the NYX Soft Matte in Stockholm lip gloss to my lips. And I'm also now setting my face with the NYX Matte Finishing Spray. And that's the end of the look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and I'll see you in the next one.